Game number two, State Green did win that first game. They did start a little bit earlier, though. But State Green did win that first game, and they are currently in game number two once again. So definitely head on over there as well, or get dual streams going, whatever you like. That's why we got multiple sources of coverage for you guys. You get to choose, pick and choose. Hopefully it makes it good for you guys. Lion Esports Club versus Team Excellent here, though. And here we are in game number one. So with that said, first things first, they once again, Lion Esports Club, we got to see them yesterday against TMSR. It took them three games, but they did take out Too Much Sugar, 2-1 in that series. And moving on here, the opponent before that, defeating Donkey Kong, of course, advancing out from that gold division, only to go back down, unfortunately, for them. But anyways, Lion Esports Club, playing with Fousey here. Swindle, I actually had him ask me that question of who do I think is going to win this series. And if I had to choose somebody, honestly, I lean a little bit towards Team Excellent. A couple of reasons. One being they are coming off, more so that Lions is coming off a disappointing loss in the Soundblaster Heroes League qualifiers, as they lost to Justice League, which meant they're going to have to play in another qualifier to try to qualify for that tournament still. Whereas also, Lions is playing with a new player in Fousey here. Fousey, not that he's a bad player by any means, but it is a new player. And even more to that, yesterday when watching them against Too Much Sugar, I really feel like this is a team which can work a lot of the time just because their skill could take them there. But they get a little too focused on wanting to kill the other team, you know, wanting to play extra aggressive, wanting to really go for hero kills, and I think that kind of hurts them in the long run when it comes to the farming game. When it comes to, there's several points yesterday against TMSR specifically, where it's in there like, they're really, I mean, they're constantly looking for kills, it's even backfiring on them, rather than just getting even further ahead. And that goes back to the classic quote I like to bring up, Artosis from StarCraft: whenever you're ahead, get further ahead, is basically what it comes down to. And it seems like Lion Esports Club, they tread that fine line of, well, we want to make some big plays, we want to go for the kills, which again, can be flashy, fun to watch, and can definitely work, but in the end, you know, might come back to hurt them in the long run. But we'll see, moving on here. Here we are once again in what is game number one here of this best out of three series. So, Lion Esports Club versus Team Excellent. The draft moving along here. A lot of chat going on with that said. Not sure what that's about. I've been focused on casting here. So, as far as the bans go, then I miss, well, it looks like I missed the initial ban. We had Prisoner, Pebbles, Engineer, and then Lodestone, it looks like. Was the ban on top of that? We had a first pick Scout coming out, followed by the Ophelia response, Master of Arms, and a Rally. So you still have that Tempest and Keeper combination coming out here. But,
Tempest.
Speaking of that, there's a Tempest and
Keeper of the Forest.
Well, it's like they were reading my mind, or more so, it's just pretty damn obvious. Tempest picked up by Lions, and Pew's like, we'll take whichever. Well, we'll take the Keeper, I guess. I mean, obviously, if Lions went went Keeper, you probably wouldn't go Tempest every Team Excellent, seeing as you already have that Ophelia. So those picks happen. Now into the banning stage. Corrupted Disciple into Fade coming out right here. And moving along. Obviously, once again, too, I know a lot of people are intrigued by, as they should be, we just have great matchups coming at you. Once again, for Cycle 4, and even as Swinemoles was talking, I really want to reiterate that. I mean, he was definitely stressing the issue that the competitive scene right now, I mean, there is this I don't know what you call it, stigma, whatever, going around that, oh yeah, the scene's dying. Honestly, the scene's been dying for 2+3 years, according to the vocal minority. I mean, you know, take it how you will, but when it comes down to it, when it comes to the quality of play, when it comes to the amount of teams that are still putting the time that they are investing, you know, into practicing, as it was making a point, scrimmaging and whatnot, and ultimately providing a good show here on the weekends and Haunter specifically, amongst other events like the Soundblaster Heroes League, like the Ultimate Series, there's still a strong competitive scene. And, you know, if you're a fan of watching Heroes of New Earth, which I assume if you're tuning in you are, you know, that's something to feel good about. You know, who cares what the ones are saying? Who cares what ultimately the numbers look like as far as viewers around you? If you love what you're doing, that's what I've always stressed, and I will continue to do it until my last breath. That if you enjoy what you're doing, man, just do it for that purpose. Don't be a sheep. Don't follow others just because you want to, you know, you want to fit in that sense. So, and I love Heroes of New Earth, and again, hopefully if you're tuning in, you do as well, and there's still quite the damn strong scene. Definitely backed it up. Again, you could even argue probably the strongest scene we've ever seen as far as the competitive scene goes. Anyways, kind of a side note there. Moving along here in what is, again, game number one. So the banning phase coming through. Corrupted, Fade, Moon Queen, Nymphora, Sandwraith, Devourer. You see the Devourer ban, and You always know, whenever there's a Devour ban, that there's most likely a guy named Super KGE in the game, and that's obviously what is over here for Lion Esports Club. So they go the Wretchedak pick, but very carry heavy band on Team Excellent with that Corrupted Moon Queen and Sandwraith. So Lions, they go the Hag themselves in the end. And that's probably going to end up being more of that carry style. So they're probably looking for that middle hero here, as Torture is the final pickup. Speaking of middle hero, obviously Pebble's already banned. I mean, you got more Axis is still on the board. It could go a little bit different, maybe something like the Gauntlet. that's a hook ability. I'm sure Super KG has experience on him. Or something else altogether. So we'll see. Again, what they end up doing here with that final pick. Blacksmith, just saying. Roll the dice. Electrician? Man, that's a hero we haven't seen in a while. I had a point there before all that. About that. Anyways, the brackets, of course, in the loser's bracket, not only do we have Justice League taking a nice prize pool to stay alive and move along here in the Cycle 4, but Team USA versus Too Much Sugar. That could easily be a winner bracket semifinals, even a winner bracket final, hell, even the grand final matchup, but it just so happens it's in the loser's bracket round 3, based on how the teams have played out so far. So, obviously, we'll keep an eye on that, and I also have a feeling I wouldn't be surprised if Beef over there, you know, if that series ends up finishing up quickly, especially with it getting started sooner, if he jumps into that one. So, you know, worst comes to worst, too. If that one's still going on, you know, most likely we'll jump into it. But anyways, at the very least, we'll have some updates for you as we move on. So with that said, we're still waiting on this final pick. 15 seconds now to go before we wrap up here for our Legion side specifically. I got the right click on Keeper. Unfortunately, that is not possible. It is going to be Pestilence, so it's definitely another one that comes to mind. And, you know, as I always say, if you're going to have Pestilence, it's nice to have that physical synergy with him. And they definitely got that in Scout, at least, and even Wretched Hag to an extent later on in the game. So that makes sense. Balfagor being right-clicked here. Let me look at the lineup real quickly. Is that possible? I mean, they got Aphelion Keeper. Warbeast is even still on the board. They already have the Suicide Keeper, though. So probably, unless we want to run a short lane Keeper here, or excuse me, short lane Warbeast even here. But they are right-clicking the Balfagor, and yeah, I mean, the short lane Balfagor definitely wouldn't be out of the question, especially with the Aphelion Keeper. I almost want to say Warbeast would be more beneficial, though, just because of that Battlecry buff, if that's the route they're going for in the end. Oh man, they need to choose quickly! It is going to be Dark Lady. Okay. Man, they were have that go to the very edge right there. The very edge. But indeed, we do see the Dark Lady pickup. All right, with that said, let me make a social media announcement. We jumped right into this game. So I want to make sure to get that out real quickly right here. We have the winner bracket semifinals coming at you. Coming at you! Lion vs. Exet happening now. There we go. Alright, so let's get it on, as the announcer says. Let's indeed. Let's move into game number one here. GLHF all around. So seeing the Pestilence pick up, being played by SuperKG. You know, as I talked about it, for the options left, you know, it definitely is. It makes sense. Like, again, obviously Pebbles being banned, Rally already being picked up, things like that. So, I guess Deadwood was still there. But, yeah, they do value the Pestilence in the end as that pick, so. Dark Lady being that final pick by Team Excellent, by the way. Obviously, they get that hard carry. And, you know, again, they were thinking about maybe something like the Warbeast, the Balfagor for that short lane to really go mass push. But I wonder if that had a little bit to do with Nox maybe not being as strong on heroes like that. You know, when it comes to Nox, obviously he's known as one of the best, arguably the best farming player in the game, but when it comes down to the heroes he plays, he does play the right-click hard carry heroes. You know, your Silhouette, your Moon Queen. I guess Dampier is a little bit of a different flavor, but it's not, like, let's be honest, difficult to do it on him either. And Dark Lady in this case, this seems to be more his style of hero in the end. You know, whether or not he has the most Warbeast or Balfagor type of experience, being with the minions and whatnot, might have had something to do with the decision, and that would not surprise me at all from Team Excellent here. So Scout is going to begin that suicide. Obviously not going up, he is going up against jungle with that said, so See if he can take advantage of that. Gonna use that Vanish here off the bat. Has a Ward of Sight on him. He's gonna place right there, but he was spotted placing that. I would not be surprised if we see a Rev Ward purchased ASAP by Pew right here to counter that. So, he doesn't have enough gold for it, obviously, at this point, but once he hits that gold mark, then he'll go ahead and purchase that up, I'm sure. And take it out. So, yeah, he should know pretty much the very good placement of where he placed it. So, it will block the first couple of the spawns right here. But after that, they should be good. Scott's going to try to get some decent positioning here. Leech some experience against Dark Lady. Accomplishing that off the bat. Oh, middle lane. Rally's actually taking some pressure. Oh, I forgot to change the UI. There we go. Alright, so into the pause we go, though. Rally was obviously taking some pressure, but I think it's safe to say he's definitely a hero that can match up against this. Obviously, with that compel, be able to get away. Bottom lane, Wretched Hag is going to be matched up against Keeper. Keeper getting pulled that extra regen. So we should be fine down there. And of course, Tempest in his own jungle. So what kind of impact can Ophelia have? Once again, with the supported side here, won't be able to take advantage of this camp, but every other camp is good to go. So I expect fine here on Ophelia to be able to get some ideal creeps, or depending on how the Haunt Gods like him. Currently has a Vagabond leader, and actually going to go over to the yellow camp, probably stack it and finish that. Yeah, Vagabond leaders are pretty good here, or unit even, or neutral creep, I guess, for doing stacked yellow camp especially. It's a good pickup for fine. Not much else. By the way, shout out to both Lions and Team Excellent. They apparently were waiting just to make sure that we would be able to jump into this game without missing a beat, so definitely shout out to these guys. It's obviously we're finishing up the other series, and it's awesome that they let us finish that, because that was a fun game. That was a fun game to watch. Who would have thought we would see a Resto Stone Hellbringer and a Jungle Deadwood being ran by Justice League that actually dominated in the end? It's not like it was a case of, oh, that's just, you know, we do see that a lot where some fun picks come out, but it just completely flops. Not there. Cyril Lade Nairpour. Does that mean he's using the restroom? Oh, no, it means that. Probably means something like that. Yeah, I think Lions, I believe they're all Swedish as well, so. But if anything, Brodex was translating for myself, so I appreciate it. Thank you. And all those non-Swedish speakers out there. I know we do have a lot of Swedes that love Haunt and tune in and play the game itself, but believe it or not, there are people that don't speak Swedish that also play the game. Yeah, Pestilence, those buffs that he's got, I mean, for good reason. I mean, there's a lot of attention drawn to this hero when those buffs first took place. Was that the Runic Shift patch, or was it after? I honestly forget now. Anyways, whenever they took place, I want to say it was after, actually. But when those buffs took place, I mean, a lot of attention came to him. Between the flight and the unit walking, I think it was. Obviously, the impale becoming physical, which I still can't believe it was magical. That just seems so weird. I mean, this hero's all about physical. His ultimate's about minusing armor. It just seems like, as far as synergy's sake, the impale just should have just been physical damage, let alone the impale. So for some reason, it was magic damage this whole time. I'm sure there was some legitimate reason behind that, obviously, but when that change happened, it was like, yeah, that kind of makes sense. And then the swarm, speaking of that, also got buffed all the way up to minus 18 armor instead of minus 15, I believe it was. Increased by 1, 2, 3 at those levels, so Quite a bit of changes, drew a lot of attention, has died off since that phase, really after like cycle 1, maybe a little bit of cycle 2, but no, picked up here. Again, he still fits as far as a solid option in that mid lane. And going up against heroes like Keeper the Force, for that matter. Don't even think I brought up that point yet. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead. We're gonna go ahead and go into a break, guys, because obviously this could take a little bit here. So we're gonna go into a break, put some music on for you guys, and we'll be back with what is gonna be game number one of Team Excellent versus Lion Esports Club. So stay tuned, guys. We'll be back. Singing. All right. Okay, guys, we are back. As you can see, coming out of the pause here. Looks like we are going to be good to go now. And move on with game number one. So, getting into the laning phase. We got Rally. They're boxing him out, although he could definitely sustain this quite well. He's still might as well keep the harassment as much as possible. See him eating through those trees. Did get stacks of regen himself, so. But I'm sure he's gonna burn through that pretty quickly. Speaking of the stacked regen, again, keeping the force at the bottom lane. Starting to use that now, Regidag. Gonna get that hot harassment up right off the bat. Super KG already 5 and 7 now, so he is making sure to deny as many creeps as possible. Trying to negate as much experience as possible, and there's even another one, so pretty good job of that. Well played with Super KG so far here in that middle lane. Like I was talking about, Ophelia had that Vagabond leader. I assume he stacked it and cleared it up. And there's some more Snotter bosses spawning for him. That's always nice. Take that top lane. Dark Hoodie also having that free farm. 11 and 7 creep farm now. We got Scout just leeching the experience, so may not be getting any creep kills, but hey, if he's getting the levels, that's what matters. Torturer did not counter ward this. I'm actually a little bit surprised by that. He's not counter ward this, and he still hasn't, and you know, if anything, maybe it just comes down to they just don't care. I mean, I guess that they had to see him place it. It was pretty obvious. And well, I mean, on top of the fact that nothing spawning there. That's the other obvious part. But, yeah. Hey, maybe there's just a point they just don't care about it. Scout comes to the middle lane, though. Rally's gonna end up falling right here. Well played by them right there. Rally, I'm not sure why he didn't compel unless it was just coming off cooldown, if he compelled earlier, or if he didn't have mana for whatever reason, but he's not able to compel right there and get away in the process. Good roam by Scout, though. Being very useful. So Jonas, a fan, helps sets up. In fact, he gets the Bloodlust kill at the middle lane. And I think he might have either finished a Ring of Teacher or Boots. He's got the Boots here. So big start for Scout. And actually gonna harass Ophelia now. And again, this is why you pick up this hero, especially against the jungle. Look at that, he's gonna take a couple of creeps right there, a third one even. And you know, again, the small things add up. I mean, he's even gonna get another one on top of that. So Ophelia's sitting here, triple stacking his camp with the Catman champion, figuring he's in a really good spot. And Scout comes in, and he's going to get the Catman. No, he ports it back just in time. Very, very close, but still. That's even going to put Ophelia further behind now. Oh, man. Jonathan fan, he is off to an excellent start. Fine, not so much anymore. Again, he was setting himself up to be pretty good. Wretched Hag, 24-4 against a 17-3 Keeper. Keeper still has a one tree left, as well as a Nature's Veil, of course, but Uzi just keeping up those auto attacks, the Haunt. Middle lane, Torture coming in invis. Is there any Rev Force on the Legion side? Doesn't look like it. That is their own, and they're going to go for a kill right here. Master of Arms chain reactions on top. Was it a little bit too much? Master of Arms, he is going to be fine, and Pilsner comes out. Now Rally's in trouble. Fork Lightning comes out. Down goes Rally. Torture also in a lot of trouble. He is probably going to fall right here. Nice hero blocking coming out from Jonas Ben, trying to buy time for Pestles to come in for the kill, and nope, but Silka will take it. They get the kill. That's what matters. That backfired completely for Team Excellent. The decision there in the first place, I mean... Yeah, it is a level 5 Rally, so no Seismic Slam, obviously, but still, he is putting out some good damage. He didn't go Demoralizing Roar, though. He did go the battle experience. Which I'm not saying, I mean, let's see, level 2 Demoralizing Roar would have been 80 damage, and it would have been the slow on top of that, which I don't think was the biggest deal in the world. Actually, maybe, I don't know. Anyways, they didn't get the kill, they got turned on, 2-for-nothing exchange. So, big picture, Team Excellent not happy after that. And this scout is clearly being, I mean, again, this was the first big scout for good reason, as we see all the time, being a big nuisance here to the Hellborn team. Now, they do have a Dark Lady again, who is getting free farm. Ghost Marchers just finished there by Nox. That's also another thing. He goes to Ghost Marchers, so I wonder, is he still going to go Energizer or not? I mean, he's building up that Soul Scream Ring for an Energizer here. Nox not missing a beat though. 42-25. Wretched Hag 41-6, however. Just keeping up there. And even Pestilence again. 31-13 now, but he's also 1-0-2 in the zero kill stats. So that definitely shines. Steam Boots already picked up. And he has another 800 gold on top of that. In the meantime, Keeper the Force level 6, but gonna just do his Ancients. Bottom lane though, a lot of push power coming. Hanskin's here. Ring of Sorcery up for another 18 seconds. But the Elementals have spawned, and he still has him for another 20 seconds here, so. They're gonna split up. Those are the level 4 Elementals. Gonna get in range finally. Tower, or Creep Wave comes in, and here, look at the tower just fall. Keeper of the Force nearby is gonna go for the deny right here. Do they have any vision? They do not. They do have dust, actually. They do have dust.
The Legion takes down the dust. Tower.
Oh, he's just out of range. Dust, dust, dust. There's the dust. Will they have enough damage? Soda Screen, the Bat Blast, of course they will. Stun comes out. They were setting that up all along. Bastets fell into the trap. The tower even still fell in favor of the Legion team. And now they're continuing to push. Team Excellence decision making, you know, it's not horrible, but it's just, it's backfiring several times now. The deny attempt to the middle lane gank. Now the top lane push in here, but even this, Master of Farms and Scouts coming in. It is Ophelia, Torture, and Dark Lady, but look at that. The Minotaur is going to be bursted down. And they're going to lose their push power. It's not in deny range at least, but no more push going to be happening just yet. It's a Lion Esports Club. A massive lead here early on. 4,500 goal lead, 3,500 experience lead. And now Rally being gone on by Pestilence. You see that damage output. Tempest coming in. He has an element of void. He stutter stepped, though. He actually started backing up for some reason. You know, not for some reason. I mean, he didn't want to be compelled right there. But the chase continues. And Pestilence will finish him off. The Gore proc to finish him.
It's a massacre.
Smackdown taunt on top of that. 5-0 hero kill advantage for Lions. This is a dominating start by them. And Nox still goes the Energizer here. So kind of stacking that Uniwalking effect on one another. Again, that's not bad because one up the other. And it still has great use. It's not that I'm questioning the Energizer pickup, but usually we see the Steam Boots and Energizer combination for that reason. On top of just Steam Boots for survivability, a little bit better, but also the attack speed. And just like any other right-click carry, attack speed always nice.
The Legion takes down a Hellborn Tower!
One of the Ghost Marchers into Energizer here. Middle tower goes down. Hellborn Courier killed, and guess what? By Scout. Just yet another one of many reasons why Scout is annoying. He got that nerf last patch. Scout players don't care. He's still very powerful. Middle lane in the meantime, speaking of that, Pestilence being locked down by the Root. He throws out the Impel. Flight comes up. Again, he doesn't take amp damage. Tempest coming in. Actually, Elemental Boy going to go off. It only catches Torturer, though. Ratchet not going to jump in. Ophelia's Touch Rosio's. The Tablet Keeper of the Force into it. Actually, compelled him into it, I should say. It does stun Tempest. And Tempest is going to fall here as a result. So it ends up being a 1-for-1, actually. And I'm making that a 2-for-1. As Pestilence did also fall. So that definitely worked out a lot better. And actually, Nox picks off Seal Kid. Able to find him off to the side. So, team excellent. Three big hero kills coming out right there. And that was after an Elemental Void was even used, remember. So, Lions just a lot of momentum here. And now here we are, middle lane.
The Hellborn takes down falling. A Legion Tower.
Wretched Hag, oh, Wretched Hag, she's coming in right here, Skeleton King Net. She's going to be able to be fine. They're running away, going for the kill on Ophelia. She's going to survive barely. Blinks away at the last second. Yeah, I was a derp earlier. I do apologize for that. Obviously, Rally, he was silenced when they jumped in 6 minutes ago. I was honestly trying to sit there. I didn't think they had a silence, but yeah, of course, Scout with the electric guy. Silenced. Prevented the Rally Compel, so. I derped. I done derped. 10 minutes in. 7-3 hero kill lead for Lion Esports Club, but once again, team excellent. At least making a bit of a push right there. And they did get the tower, right? Yeah, they did get the tower, so. Dark Lady's farm is still very impressive. 446 gold per minute, so. Life 2 picked up. Rune Cleaver on the way. Bottom lane. Keeper of the Force being collapsed on. He doesn't have a root. Doesn't matter. He even got flanked right there by Master of Arms. That was just an all-out gank right there. Wretched Hag already has a life brand. And Fousey is really coming along nicely here. So, can't forget about Fousey here on Hag. I mean, it's obviously a lot of talk about Dark Lady for that freeform, but Fousey on Wretched Hag, the early Grimoire is coming along
the
very nicely.
Takes down a Legion
Tower. Damn pure effect necessarily, but damn good one at that. Nox, though, she does push in the top lane by herself, but here goes the secondary tower bottom lane. This is going to be an easy kill.
The Legion takes down a Hellborn Tower!
On the tower, so. Tower exchange, but obviously a secondary for a first one. Lion Esports Club will take that. So it continues to be a case of Dark Lady. She is getting scary. I mean, that Rune Cleaver is coming. Once again, that's obviously that farming tool, but I mean, with Dark Lady, as we always talk about, though, as far as synergy goes, yes, it's a great farming tool for us, just like anyone else, really, in this case, but just synergize with her abilities, too, pretty nicely, between the charging strikes, with those Dark Blades activated. I mean, you can hit pretty damn hard in the AoE presence in those fights, so it's not the battle tool necessarily that they're looking for, but if a fight comes to it, definitely make use of it, and very likely will, because clearly Lion Esports Club, they're making a statement that, they're just keeping the early aggression up. Keeper of the Forest buys Ghost Marchers here. And I actually really wonder about that. Because unless they have Plated Greaves being made on Ophelia, probably would have preferred to see the Plated Greaves here on the Hellborn team. I mean, talk about physical presence, man. Pestilence and Scout, and even Wretched Hag in the later game. Going to be a lot of it. So any bit of armor you can get helps. Portal Key picked up by Super KGE. That's his own Rev Ward, so not the biggest deal despite him being Invis. Oh, they're going to find a jump here on a rally. Will they be able to collapse for the kill? He has Master of Arms kind of running over. Not really. No, they're not going to go for it. He's going to continue to roam, actually. He will find Dark Lady. That's a better target. If they can get a kill on Dark Lady here, this could be big. He needs the support, though. He can't jump by himself. And actually, Dark Lady, look at that, falling back. Another Rev, but again, it is theirs. They're going for Kongor. Uh-oh. They have a Rev Ward down, though. They will see Pestilence. He's on the uphill currently, so they can't see him. Oh, this is going to be a big jump here by Lions. They're setting up. They do not have Tempest with them, though. Scout's actually going to be scouted first. He needs to run away. That was a silly move. I mean, you got to figure they have vision. He does survive in the end. Pestilence now, rather, obviously,
the
he's
Legion
being seen.
Takes down a Hellborn
meanwhile,
Tower.
Hanskin's off there. There we go. The pick up Pelt Drop. The Bad Blast on top. A lot of damage. Ophelia's Touch going to be coming out. Marksman shot onto Ophelia. She barely survives for now. Scout's caught by the rear, though. Here we go with her turn. Dark Lady jumps in with the Dark Blades. Down goes Scout right there. But now Dark Lady in some trouble. Gorprok coming out. But Pestilence on the run. The impalement doing plenty of damage and actually getting them to run away. But Dark Lady goes back on him. Wretched Hag jumps in. And down goes Dark Lady. The ultimate from Dark Lady was up. with the cover of darkness clearly causing some issues. Makes sense for some of the movement right there. Rally gets caught up, but was that the wrong choice? I think so. Fuji goes back in. He ends up dying. Scout comes back in, and Rally comes down. Scout that is after a buyback, and now Keeper of the Forest. He is vulnerable. Swarmer's on him. Silence comes out. Doesn't matter. He's going to be fine. Tempest finally able to get here, but actually they are going to chase. Portal Key comes out. He kills the Minotaur. They kill Keeper. And Lion Esports Club, in the end, they are victorious. Again, a buyback was used on Scout, but definitely, definitely worth it. You could imagine how different that could have been if Tempest was there from the very beginning. Obviously, he was kind of pushing the top lane while that was happening, and you know, he eventually ported over here to join them, but... So it was kind of awkward for Lions, even though they had the advantage of the site there initially. They weren't really able to get the best jump because of the lack of Tempest. And speaking of Tempest, he's going to fall back before too much else happens. So, more momentum built up. The Rune Cleaver is stalled here on Dark Lady. She has the one broadsword, still needs the other. And look at this, stealing some Ancients in the meantime. I believe there's only a single stack there, but still Scott taking those out. And leaves one behind. It leaves a present behind for when the respawn does look to take place. Smart job there. Keeper is building a Soul's Bulwark now. So, yeah, that goes back to the armor idea. So, I mean, I assume we're going to see a Plate of Grief on Ophelia. She's still sitting on the red boots. She's prioritizing Astrolabe, which obviously is fine. Look at that, the Plate of Grief on top of the Soul's Bulwark, and pretty much necessary is this game, I think. As well as the Ring of the Teacher, for that matter, which obviously is on Ophelia. And Keeper. I'm sure, and I wonder what that said, if we're still going to see an Abyssal Skull here on Dark Leader or not. We do see Initiation onto Torture. Torture gonna drop very fast with a level 2 Swarm. They catch him. Marksman shot on a Keeper of the Forest. He has Invis, not gonna matter though. Swarm is not applied. Actually, Keeper is gonna be fine, or was it? Nope, not applied. Must have still been on cooldown right there. So gonna be fine. Okay, just got an update. It looks like, I believe so, Stay Green. Sounds like they did win that series, 2-0, and I believe Coldcast is looking to cover that Team USA versus TMSR series, so definitely head on over there as well, get the dual stream going for that series as well if you haven't yet. Rally gets picked up in the meantime, Tempest Ultimate Pulse and Keeper, it's not going to be stopped, Keeper will fall, Torture not much you can do, Rally buyback, he does stun Pestilence, there's a jump from Dark Lady, Seismic Slam, they are going to finish off Pestilence, Rune Cleaver just purchased there by Dark Lady, and here they go with the chase. Wretched Ag blinks away, poured out right there, and it will be they will fight them off in the end, but again, buyback used by Rally. They get the one kill on Pestilence, and that's really it, but they do have the Rune Cleaver now on Dark Lady. Once again, though, will we see an Abyssal Skull pick up? They already have the two Ring of Teachers, but I guess, you know, Abyssal Skull is just a great extra farming tool on Dark Lady, and, you know, the more armor, especially on himself, definitely wouldn't hurt. So to answer my own question, I think so. Grimoire Power just finished on Hag. Fuzi's farm still continues to be very impressive. 485 gold per minute on Wretched Hag right here. Mighty Blade on Scouts, picking up Abyssal Skull. Obviously, he has his own. Pestilence, 2100 gold saved up. Doesn't have the Mighty Blade yet, though. So still a little bit of ways off. He might purchase it right here. There you go. 1900 plus gold saved up on Tempest in the meantime. He's going straight in the portal key. I'm looking here at the Hellborn side. There's still several ways, even with the Shrunken Head, to stop that ultimate, so. At the same time, I don't know if they're necessarily relying on him for a big ulti on this team, and they still have great jump with Pestilence. They have some good movement as a team. There's another courier pickoff. Jeez. Scout is so annoying. Even it's annoying for me, man. It's like, God! I'm a spectator. I'm like, Scout, stop! That's gotta be frustrating, man. Alright, bottom tower goes down to the first tower, but here we go into the base. Legion team going to the base right here. I'm not gonna commit too much. Open side does scare them off. No buybacks or anything like that you use. It's just more so them respawn, or not respawning even, but getting back to base. And, you know, kind of rinse and repeat here. This is what we happen at the top tier level, Lion Esports Club. They'll push into the base, get them to respond, use resources to get back, and then they'll clean up their jungle. So that's what we're seeing right here. Coming out, and it's showing. 2700 gold now saved up on Tempest. Again, So at this rate, it looks like he is going to be going for something like that Shrunken. And I kind of even wonder if that's the best. I almost want to say he might even be best off going for more just utility here in the end. Something like straight Resto. I wouldn't even be surprised if Restoration Stone is actually the better choice here. It is hard to do that, though, without a Shrunken altogether, because without the Shrunken, then you're vulnerable to many other things, like Torturer and Rally. So, yeah, that's where I probably actually, when I'm thinking about it, the Shrunken still makes the most sense, and then eventually the Restoration Stone. Speaking of the Shrunken, Super KG once again, trying to get that on himself. I'm sure Wretched Agatha the same way. Dark Lady does go the Quick Blade here. So we're not going to see an Abyssal Skull on her. Still no Plated Greaves either. Soul's Bulwark still not picked up either. Was that just purchased by chance? I feel like he's heading back. Yeah, okay, so Soul's Bulwark they do have. And I wonder if he's even just going to keep that defensive here. Kind of trying to, maybe instead try to work with it, but... still a couple other sources that they could use in terms of armor. Because again, Super KG already applying minus 12 armor. And they're going to be looking at minus 18 eventually. And then there's the goo. Yeah, it hurts. A lot of minus armor. Stealing some more ancients, so Legion team doing a good job of taking those away, but Nox still managing. I mean, I swear, it seems like Alliance has been in the Hellborn jungle more this game than Exilin themselves, but Nox still somehow is managing 513 gold per minute. They just stole another pair of ancients, and again, it seems like they've done that at least a couple times, but Nox is still managing 510 gold per minute here. I mean, dude knows how to farm. And Firebrand, yeah, gets the Firebrand here. I wonder if we are going to see that full Doombringer if he goes... oh, not Doombringer. Full Dawnbringer if we're going to see the Searing Light or the Frozen Light first. I almost want to say it's going to be Frozen Light would be the better choice first. Mainly because, you know, you already have your great farming tool in that... excuse me, in that Rune Cleaver. And bulking up a little bit more. Just in case, wouldn't be the worst thing in the world. That's also if he even is going for that. I'll see Geometer's Bane. Definitely not out of the question either. Especially with something like the Pestilence with that Swarm. Ooh, the chase is on! Pestilence, though, speaking of enemy, Portal Key's away. And he's gonna be fine. Wretched Hag, Soul Scream Ring, Sacrificial Stone picked up on her. I'm messing up on the names today. Sacrificial Stone, just picked up by Wretched Hag. So they too, feeling like they need to tank up a little bit themselves. Is there a Soul's Bulwark by chance with that said? Not yet. I'm sure Pestilence, that might be his next item choice. He's got the Shrunken finish now. Plated Greaves are finished on Ophelia, so that is good to see here for Team Exilin. So I believe right now it's really the Abyssal Skull is the only thing that they're missing at this point as far as maximizing their armor. And of course the full demonic, but you can only do so much here if you keep her. Oh, Torturer! Double damage scout! Three shots him. And he's gonna stick around for more perhaps. Keeper of the Forest, silence comes out. Nope, gonna run away. So not gonna go for more, but free pick on a pew there playing the Torturer. Keeps him locked down. Nox, another 2,700 gold saved up. So actually, it looks like he might be going straight into that Geo's Bane here. Another 1,500 gold on Pestilence, 3,000 gold on Hag, still needs that Shrunken herself. 2,500 on Scout, so the Brutalizer is just about there. Obviously a lot of just gold being pulled up here on both sides in that farming state, so. But of course, Lion Esports Club. I mean, the longer you wait, the more obvious that Dark Lady's just going to get bigger and better, and it's hard to go against the fact that Dark Lady's just one of the hardest carries in the game, especially when you let her get the farm she's looking for. Not having the shrunken head is definitely hurts her mobility quite a bit, and won't be able to mitigate. And actually, no Mystic Vestments either. Not about that. I've learned a lot about that lately. Hashtag Vestments. Dark Lady sitting at 1,270 life, so that on top of the Ghost Margers, you know, she is damn squishy. That's actually really standing out more and more now. Again, when you're going up against a Hag-style carry, who has that Grimoire, who's level 17, that's going to be some quick burst. Now, they're going for Congo right here. This should be a Congo kill. There's no vision here from the Legion team. They're kind of heading over, but they're going to be a little bit too late, I believe. Tempest is here, but again, not going to happen. Dust even being used just in case. There's Conger the acid. Killed. Conger goes down. Token of life on Nox. So again, he is really squishy, but he now has a second life right here. And once he finishes, actually, okay, he's bone straight shrunken here, it looks like. So now with the shrunken head, that definitely changes some things. Is it going to be that? I assume so. He just sold the homecoming stone for that slot, so that makes sense. What did I see? Soul's Bulwark picked up by Pestilence, and yeah, there's the Shrunken, there's the Portal Key on Keeper. So giving them some strong response to Tempest, especially now that he has the Shrunken. So Keeper wants to be able to position himself.
The Legion takes down a Hellborn Tower!
Last Outer Tower destroyed by Lion Esports Club. So several big item pickups coming up by both sides here. Here we go into the base, looks like. Keeper the Forest, he is still at the bottom lane. Okay, he is TPing back now. Not gonna happen. See, Lion says this is not the time. Especially with Dark Lady having that token. Do not want to fight into their base into that, so. Definitely unfortunate for Lion's Esports Club that they get that Conger, because here we go for Team Excellent now. They found a much more of an opening here. They are down 14,000 gold and 10.5 thousand experience, but Dark Lady is deadly. 535 gold per minute, has a shrunken now. Gonna work with the fireman. Uh-oh, gonna be caught right here. She gets the silence off on a Pestilence. Bat Blast was not able to connect. And look at Dark Lady, the difference that shrunken head is making. She's trying to chase down even with another Impale Sun. Not gonna happen. She has charging strikes. And down goes Super KGE. That is frustrating because Super KGE, he actually portal key when he didn't need to. And that split second with the portal key allowed Dark Lady to activate the Dark Blades and actually charging strikes first to silence him. So he could not get the initial impale off, which meant the Bat Blast didn't hit and it snowballed from there. So again, those very small things, just a fraction of a second. And before you know it, Dark Lady tears up Pestilence even with Wretched Dagger right there. And now here comes the push. So a huge, huge kill coming out for Team Excellent. Wretched Hag, you know, again, who talks to stress how squishy Dark Lady is, but the shrunken head out was almost all the difference that made right there. Able to get that off right before the Bat Blast came out. They push the top lane, they're going middle. You see Scout, he's just going to counter push in the meantime. Middle lane, though, easily taken out. Bottom tower is still there.
Hellborn takes down a Legion Tower.
Not going to go for it, though. Resurrection on Pestilence, not going to risk it. They need to fall back. So that gap definitely closing quite a bit. It's still a lead. Definitely solid lead for Lion Esports Club. Of 11.5k. As well as 10,000, but...
New Earth's Blessing!
His touch is even used right there. I don't know if that actually saved anyone or not, or that was just more of a healing out for the purpose of healing, using the cooldown. Did I make a point of... Oops, yeah. Frostburn is what I meant. Did I say Frozen Light or Searing Light? Well, damn those lights. There's the Frostburn, speaking of that. So, yeah, he does go that first to help the bulking up a little bit more. And I assume it's going to be finished through Dawnbringer. I mean, at this point, no, not a huge reason not to. Tablet on Rally. So Wretched Hag, I mean, what item she's going to go for next definitely determined a lot right here. Will it be more of that CC tool? Will it be more of the damage output? The Savage Mace style, or... I mean, there's not going to be a Resto Stone here on Keeper anytime soon. He's clearly going for more of the... I wonder if he is going to finish a full Demonic or not, if he's going to try to get the Resto Stone now, but... Especially if he goes for full Demonic, you're not concerned about a double root. So you already have the Shrunken Head to get out of the first one. So yeah, the likelihood of something like a Geometus Bane probably up in question. If you're Wretched Hag, something that could be in the question is something like a Null Fireblade on Scout. That would be not a bad pickup. And actually, he does. Wow, so he finishes the Shrunken Head. That kind of just hit me, but I thought he was working on the Brutalizer. But he does go the Shrunken Head route. And now he gets another 2,600 gold saved up. So we'll see where he goes here. But yeah, again, back at Wretched Hag. What will we see from him? I mean, they have a lot of, they already have a lot of physical threat between Pestilence and Scout, I think, so. Although Pestilence is more than Initiator in the end. But that's where I think something like the Sheepstick is probably more, makes more sense here. For Wretched Hag. Double damage rune just picked up by Hag. That now to use. And gonna push the middle lane. So you see Team Excellent, they're going to the bottom. They're gonna pressure this last outer tower, but they can't do that for long. Their base is now being beat on here. Invulnerability coming out. Are they gonna commit to the tower kill? Looks like Torch are gonna stay behind just to support, so not the biggest deal in the world.
The Legion!
Check out the tower kill, but the middle tower falls, and look at Lions immediately reacting. They go bottom, they're gonna get a deny in the end, so, and actually get a hero kill on top of that. So that worked out pretty much perfectly for Lion Esports Club. They get the middle tower kill, they deny the bottom tower, and they get a hero kill on top of that. Torture, so. That worked out very well for Lions. And that lead gets even bigger now. Shaman's Headdress picked up by Keeper. Interesting. They're finding themselves in a spot and they're not sure. Oh, Tempest. Yeah, I don't know why he thought that would be a good idea.
Serial killer.
Oops.
You're dead.
Meanwhile, Rowley catches Master of Arms. He is going to get the kill, but at what cost right here? Will cost him his life, so. Master of Arms, the main support, ends up falling right there. He had a Void Talisman. I'm surprised he couldn't get that off. Obviously, the Compel, though, and then just stunned him long enough. But yeah, that top lane. Tempest trying to Shrunken Head TP out right in front of a Keeper of the Forest. Not going to happen. As we see right there, get stopped. Brutalizer is now picked up by Scout. But where was he? Oh yeah, the Shaman's Headdress on Keeper of the Forest. It's not often you see a Soul's Bulwark and a Shaman's Headdress on the same hero. Especially in this, I mean... Yeah, I can definitely see where you're coming from. They want a Barrier Idol, and it's not going to be happening on Ophelia here in the near future. Bastet's Farming is a little bit better, and looks like they might be valuing... Well, they got a Neophyte's Book here on Ophelia. I wonder if they're just going to build that into Gnome's Wisdom here. So not going to go the Abyssal Skull, just go the Gnome's Wisdom route instead. Or even the Tablet, but... Anyways, Frostwolf Skull finished! Interesting! By Dark Lady there, so she is really bulking up. Has a Frostseal Skull now, so does not go the full Dawnbringer. Oh, nice dodge within the Minotaur in the background. They jump on a Rally. Rally being person gets a Compel off. He's barely alive. Pestilence diving big time. He will kill him, but in the meantime, back here. Oh, Dark Lady being locked down by the Tempest Ultimate. Where's the damage follow up? Shrunken Head is up by Dark Lady, so it's not coming from Wretched Hag. Marksman shot. She's going back to the well, and now Pestilence falls back. Pestilence got very distracted right there. If he'd have been so focused on Rally, I think that could have been a dead Dark Lady, but he really, really wanted to commit to that Rally kill, which he got. He does force a buyback. But yeah, you gotta wonder if he was instead back there to maybe look to try to beat down Dark Lady in that Tempest Ultimate, different story. But Darkity did just buy their Frosty Skull as well. She does have, oh, a fake fallback. This is going to catch him off guard. Brodex was coming up. He will fall. Root comes out from Keeper. Will it be enough? Darkity jumps in. Tempest Pulse. He already used Elemental Void now. Now the disarm on Darkity. That's big from Scout. The locked in. The Brutalizer procs coming out on Sheriff. There's the bash. And down goes Darkity. Keeper the Force. He's in trouble too. Keeper goes down. A hat trick coming out for Seal Kid of all players. Seal Kid picks up the hat trick. Ophelia's chased down. Fuzi will get the double tap, and that will complete the genocide. The fake fallback does it right there in favor of Lions. And they're going to clean up the racks now. And that could even be game. Again, there's no buybacks other than what he got. Keeper and Ophelia, that's not going to do anything for you, though. That's the GG well played. Game number one goes to Lionese Sports Club here in this best out of three series. So that end fight especially, I mean, the choice to go Frostal Skull, especially at that timing when you're being pushed in, obviously, you know, you could definitely question that. You really can from Nox, and whether that was best to either save for buyback at the point or... It's hard to say that Frostal Skull was a horrible pickup in that choice, honestly, so I guess you can't say that. You could, hindsight, you could say maybe you should have saved for buyback, but obviously, again, that is hindsight. In the end, you know, big picture though. Again, they tried to lean on the Dark Lady like Excellent does in most games. I mean, lean on Nox. Okay, that's how they build their lineups around. They build their playstyle around that. Get him the farm, and eventually have him take over. It seemed like they had their marks of that at times.